What's going on, everybody, and welcome to Rock and Roll True Stories. And one of the strangest stories that's happened the last couple weeks actually happened on Thanksgiving night. So the Musonia School and Museum in North Hollywood has had a pretty long association with Randy Rhoads' family, as Randy himself was a teacher there prior to his death, and his mother has also helped run the school. So on Thanksgiving night, a theft had occurred at the school, with thieves taking memorabilia, including some of Randy's gear and more. And among the items taken was the first guitar that Rhoads ever played. So after hearing about the theft, his former bandmate Ozzy Osbourne put up a $25,000 reward for any info that would lead to the return of the items or the capture and prosecution of the thieves. So it turns out that those items, really some of the items, have actually shown up. So according to the Los Angeles ABC News affiliate, a person walking by a dumpster spotted some of the missing Rhoads items while she was walking her dog. So local resident Bobby Fredericks said she spotted a guitar and photos in a dumpster as she was walking her dog early Sunday morning on December 8th. When she saw a news report about the theft, it finally dawned on her what she had finally come across. So the passerby would say, "As I was laying in bed not feeling well, when it came on, I was like, wait a minute, oh my God. I ran all the way back over there and it was still there. Somebody else started to see it and call the police. And while waiting on the police, she pulled a few of the items out of the dumpster to protect them from the rain." So Randy Rhoads' nephew would tell ABC, "We're really thankful for the Osbournes who sent a message out to the community yesterday. And I think that's what spread the word further. We're grateful to the Osbournes for helping promote the news about it." So that does it for today's video. Thanks for watching, guys. So if you tune in tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern, we're going to be having a video about Michael Bolton's metal days and his like adult-oriented rock days. So before he became the singer that, you know, he's well known for, especially in the 90s, he tried his hand at becoming like a hard rock and metal singer before he finally found his sound. And it's a pretty fascinating story. So check that out at 10 a.m. Eastern, guys. Hope you guys have a great rest of the week. Take care.